Assalamu alaikum, welcome back. We are back home. We are back in the States. I'm just gonna show you what I got from Uzbekistan. Since I'm jet lagged, I'm gonna be making an early breakfast and I'm gonna show you how I organize my hijabs and I'm gonna make delicious goat kidney for lunch. So these are the teas I picked up on our way to Xiamen. So if you've seen the last vlog, the trip to Xiamen, this is some of the stuff I picked up on that trip. Honestly, I'm just a tea junkie, like especially if they're decaf and I haven't tried it before, I will definitely pick that tea up. These were so unique to me. I have yet to figure out what the names are of these teas. If you recognize any of the tea, you can leave me a comment and let me know. So the first item I'm going to show you was actually gifted to me. The rest, I bought them. I was specifically interested in buying handmade Uzbek tea cups with teapot. The pot and the pan. I really wanted something that, again, was handmade. It's got substantial weight to them. And then I've got a set of Turkish teacups. The other thing I'm really excited about is the knives. I think it's so essential to have a good knife in your kitchen because one is safe and two, just more efficient and just more fun. These are all the stuff I got from there. Well, I did get some other things from my family, but I thought these are some of the more interesting things to show you. I'm going to roast these potatoes in the oven. I added some ghee and Italian seasoning, some salt. The reason I'm using ghee is because I don't have oil. I ran out of oil, but that's fine. Ghee works perfect as well. We're gonna have some eggs with it and some coffee. We're gonna drink coffee today because we miss a good coffee. We haven't had good coffee in Uzbekistan, so we mainly drink tea over there. I need to empty my luggage, and the sooner I get to it, the better because I hate emptying luggages. But anyways, I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna show you how I organize my hijabs. So I've been using this hack to organize my hijabs for years because it's just an easy way to see all of the hijabs you have, and then you can choose whatever you want very easily without wasting time. So I just get one of these multi-layer hangers and I hang them according to which ones I want together. These are actually all the neutral hijabs that came out of my luggage. I took all of these for my Uzbekistan trip. So I mostly packed jersey hijabs because that's what I mainly wear no matter what the season, because I just love how comfortable they are. And especially when they are made from good quality material and well made. So these are my old sets from Uzbekistan, along with these clear cups that I'm gonna donate. I wanna make something quick, and one of my go-tos is goat kidney. We have a halal meat that's like our neighbor, and whenever I need something really quick, I just grab one of these goat kidney packages. I think this one is around 8 ounce, and I'm gonna make that for lunch. So I always make sure I have lots of onion, lots of garlic whenever I make organ meat. That is crucial for me. And for fat, I'll be using ghee because I'm out of oil. I'm out of a lot of things. I really need to do grocery, but ghee works just as well, if not better. So I'll be using ghee. In fact, I've used ghee throughout the whole day today. I actually made this ghee before I left for our trip, so thank God I had this. I'm gonna saute the onion and I'm gonna let it develop some color a little bit. And then I'm gonna add my garlic and let that saute for like a minute. And then I'm gonna add the kidney. As soon as I add the kidneys, I'm gonna hit it with salt and mix that in right away. I'm chopping up some cilantro so I can also throw that in there. I'm gonna hit it with my cumin. I think that cooking is not about recipes, honestly. I feel like, sure, when you're a beginner, you probably need recipes to follow, but as you grow in your cooking journey, you should really aim for mastering techniques. And I think that that is what makes you a great cook, not following a recipe to the dot. I love chilies and almost everything, honestly. Add one because these small ones are super spicy, so one will do the job. In case you are interested in the ingredient amount, I'm gonna pop that in the description box, so go ahead and check that out if you are interested. I turned off the heat. I'm gonna add the rest of my cilantro for garnish, and I'm gonna add good olive oil. I always like to do that at the end. I like to add olive oil off the heat, and that makes it even more delicious. So typically in my culture, people eat organ meat with bread usually, but honestly we don't have a preference. Like, we will eat it with bread, we will eat it with pasta or even rice, so it really doesn't matter. I think it tastes delicious with all of those things. So today I'm actually gonna pair it with quinoa, brown rice, pasta. We haven't had regular pasta, like the semolina pasta, for so long. Like, I can't differentiate between the quinoa brown rice and the regular pasta. Honestly, it tastes, to me, to us, to my family, it doesn't really taste that different. So we usually just buy the quinoa brown rice. I'm not gonna use all of the pasta, and I'm gonna save the rest of it in this dish. I'm gonna add some olive oil just to prevent sticking, and then it'll be ready whenever I need pasta for any other dish. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed my videos, please hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed already, please do so. It helps me out a lot. Inshallah, I'll talk to you later.